Hey everyone, and welcome back to another gameplay highlight video of what I think this week is one of the best eShop deals available, which is Wonder Boy, the Dragon's Trap, that is currently 60% off, knocking the price down to only $7.99. Now, because time is sparse this week, I just need to let you know that this sale is ending in about 35 hours after the posting of this video. Basically, it's ending on October 7th. So if you do want to pick this game up, make sure you move fast. Now, just to situate us a little bit, this is the remake of a 2D action platformer with some very light beginnings of Metroidvania elements. But this is the remaster of a Sega Master System game. What that means is that although the graphics and the gameplay are now up to par with modern standards, some of the level designs do show sort of old tendencies from that era. However, I do think nonetheless that out of all the Wonder Boy remasters, this is like my second favorite, with maybe only Monster Boy and the Cursed Kingdom being above this one. So if you were looking at some retro action platformer fun, this one is a definite excellent pickup. Now, let's dive right in. We're going to go through about 10 minutes of gameplay just to give you guys an idea of the feeling of this game. Now, as usual, to make sure that we're not doing any spoilers, I started a brand new game. We're very early to the beginning of the game, but we're not at the very beginning. Why? Because I wanted a section that nonetheless will give you an idea of how the overall gameplay plays out. Now, basically, you play as Wonder Boy. Unfortunately, every time you beat a boss in this game, you're going to get cursed with a new animal form, meaning that each time you beat a boss, the gameplay is always going to switch up. Now, eventually, you'll have somewhat control over these different forms, but to begin with, unfortunately, you'll sort of have to deal with whichever form is thrust upon you at different points in the game. Now, basically, what I did is we are here in the hub world. That's why I said that there's slight Metroidvania elements, because in between sort of each mission or each section of the game, you'll be back in this hub world. And before we actually jump out on the adventure, there is one little option I want to show you. At any point, you can hit the ZR trigger, and you can actually play in a version of the game that looks very similar to the Master System version of the game. So if you prefer the true retro feeling of the game, you can actually just hit the ZR trigger at any point of the game and switch between one and the other. Now, today in the gameplay, I just switched back. We're going to be playing in the modern version because I do think that this is where a lot of people are going to be spending most of their time. So as I said, what we're gonna do, it's gonna take about 10 minutes. We're going to run through the first sort of dungeon, if you will, because that's pretty much where we're at. We're at the first real dungeon of the game, because I don't want to ruin anything, but when the game starts out, you're in a dungeon, but it's not really the first dungeon. It's more like a dungeon to just teach you the basics, the tutorials, before the game really starts. Now, basically, as you can see here, the mechanics are pretty simple for the gameplay. You jump with B, you have a different attack with Y. Depending on your animal form, that version of the attack will change. Right now we spit fire, and basically as you kill enemies, they will drop things. If you look at the top right, we're collecting money that will help us to buy items. We also right now have a life potion that will refill our health bar if we run out of hearts. And lastly, we have our magic. If you look, I'm cycling through them now, but you will be picking up pickups, which are basically magic spells that you can activate with the A button simply. And for the basic gameplay, I would say that's about it. Everything else will come from your different animal forms. So the gameplay, as I said, will switch up a lot in this game, which is actually pretty fun for a retro style game like this, because it really keeps things fresh and new every few hours of gameplay. I would say that on average, a person will play through this game in about, I would like to say 4 to 5 hours, like for a first playthrough. However, I do want to say that once you really get used to this game and, you know, you sort of know where you're going, you can sort of blast through it in a couple of hours. I would say 2 to 3 hours max, the average person, once they actually know the game by heart, will be able to blast through it. By the way, today I am playing on normal. I'm not playing on easy. And basically, there is an easy function here, which will basically give you more potions and different, make the enemies do a little bit less damage. And basically, if you need any help, don't feel bad. You can start on easy. You're not losing out anything storyline-wise. It is really just going to make your journey a little easier. You can move on to normal, and there is a hard mode as well. So right here, we just entered the first dungeon, so we are going to make our way through the different traps. This game really, like I said, does live up to its name, the Dragon's Trap, where all the dungeons are filled with different obstacles and different traps. Now, this is a very short dungeon, I'm going to let you know right away. It is the first dungeon, like I said, outside of the tutorial one, so don't, you know, it is sort of normal. But at the same time, it gives you an overall decent idea of the overall gameplay. And at the end, like I said, I don't want to ruin too much. I want some of the animal forms to be surprises. But we will be seeing one new animal form if I do beat the boss, which should technically not be an issue because basically, generally, he's pretty easy once you know his basic pattern. So we just picked up a key. This is an old school design game. Like I said, you'll be picking up keys that you need to unlock doors. So you have to find a key, then you get to a door, you can unlock it, and you can proceed through the dungeon. There's also a ton of unlockables that are hidden throughout the game. So it is honestly, although it's a retro game, it has a reputation for a reason. It was a very good game based on Master System standards. And the remaster does do some quality of life upgrades that are really worth it. So if you do want a, like I said, a really solid action platformer, this is a good one. However, like I said, the level designs and the gameplay designs are maybe a little basic by today's standards. The game does get a little more complex towards the end, but it maybe never hits the quite what we're used to nowadays with, let's say, retro revival platformers. So we're dodging here all the different fireballs. Well, I'm going to take a hit there, unfortunately. I missed that jump there. Now, this game plays very well with the D-pad. You can use the analog stick as well, but, you know, I'm a little bit old school on that fact. I use the D-pad. So here we're going to... He's a little rough. We're going to try to jump. I think we're going... the boomerang's not going to work. I'm on the wrong one. Okay, if we get enough momentum like that... Oh, we can make it through. We're not going to deal with him now because that one can be a little iffy. You have to time your fire right before you hit the bottom. It's a little annoying and we're going to just skip by him. So that was maybe not the best tactic, but it worked. I unfortunately wasn't getting the timing down there for that guy. But nonetheless, I do think we are going to progress pretty well and we're getting pretty close to the boss area. So we just have, and you can use your fire to block projectiles, by the way. I didn't mention that. So different animals will have different ways of blocking projectiles. Some animals actually use weaponry. So you'll see that you have an inventory system here that we're going to take a look at for a couple of seconds. If we look at the inventory system, you do have different shields, different swords, different armor that you can collect. And basically, as you collect the different armor, when you're using an animal form that uses these armor items, well, basically, you can power yourself up. Now, you know, you do have a regular human form that you will eventually get back to in the game, but we're going to leave that as a surprise to when that happens. Now, we are at our first boss, which is the Mummy Dragon. These bosses are pretty easy. You just have to basically hit them in the face. Now, all it is timing for when he's coming at you, and unfortunately, I'm doing pretty poorly once again. Now, unfortunately, I got sort of stun-locked there in his attack, which is unfortunate. We're probably going to use our potion here. It's not too bad. We have a couple of them, so we can afford to do better. Okay, so now, there... I was playing on easy. This would have made this a little easier. It reduces the number of projectiles. So we'll use a potion there. We've got him about halfway down. We just have to dodge under his attacks. Unfortunately, I was trying to rush it a bit. Should have maybe taken my time and wait till he's lower. So one more shot and we should be able to do that. And there we go. We have our first boss down. And basically, like you see, we get hit with a curse and we will be getting into our next animal form, which is a tiny mouse. Now, the mouse does have a different ability, which is basically that he can walk on walls. So the difference with the mouse is that basically he will allow you to walk on walls, which once again, like I said, changes up a lot of the gameplay. Because for example, here, you can fight the enemies, or if you can manage to stick yourself to the wall, which can sometimes be a little challenging, you can just run around your enemies. So as you can see, the gameplay here is going to swap around on a regular basis. So this was a slightly shorter video than yesterday's edition, simply because we're going to do two back-to-back. And overall, I don't want to ruin too much of this game since it is an action platformer that has a lot of surprises for you. But I do think that this small demonstration of the game does give you an idea of what to expect from it, and if this game is something you're going to want to pick up or not. As I said yesterday, don't forget to leave me down below in the comments if you do like these highlight type videos, and do you think you'll be picking up Wonder Boy and the Dragon's Trap? And on the way out, don't forget that if you did like this video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to the video if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell so you know when all my future videos come out. As usual, I hope I'll see you in my next video.